Emotions were running high on last night's episode of The Bachelorette, leaving one contestant with no option but to leave.
Where are you going? No.
No. No.
He's in normal clothes and his mic's off. And I just was like, no, you're not going.
No, it's not about anything that's happened tonight. I need to talk to you.
Okay. Properly. Just us.
I thought I would have done
that. Oh my God. What? When?
I honestly, I want to be like the best version I can be. Boy. But with everything that's going on, I honestly don't feel like I can be.
Okay.
Oh, as if you couldn't love him anymore. And if that wasn't enough, last night Angie decided to send home fireman Jamie, and they both join us now. Please welcome Kerri-Anne and Jamie.
Yeah! Okay, I'm gonna just say, there has been, you two guys have been like the most divisive characters, bachelors this season. You, for, you know, you were naked during the life drawing and totally starkers. You, okay, I'm just telling you what the internet says, stage 5 clinger. No, they did.
Stage 10.
Yeah, stage 10. I'm not making this stuff up. I'm on there, you know? And so what do you have to say when people say that you were like a stage 5 clinger, well, you're crazy? What do you think?
Just to make me more of a villain, just watching Ciarran just now, I think I just stole his jacket as well. So it makes it even worse. But I think a lot of the stage 10 clinger feedback was warranted, to be honest.
Really? Oh, yeah.
Definitely, I was quite intense.
She made it a bit crazy.
Yeah, I owned it. I was quite intense. Maybe a stage 6. Do you think?
What made you like
you were quite up there, mate.
I was a 10. some of it was warranted. I went in there for Angie and Angie only, and it's a very competitive environment. It was.
Yeah.
So were you actually were you head over heels in love with her, or were you driven by the competition to win?
I had watched Angie's progression in the jungle, and that really made me. Why are you laughing?
I think we're talking. The film's called Fatal Attraction.
I'm not even talking about a parent yet.
Yeah. After the parents, you are.
I'm done. No roses. So after the parents.
Were you surprised to go last night?
No. I knew I was on the chopping block last night. I knew it was time for Jamie to exit the Bachelorette. But there's a lot of things, a lot of my actions on that show I don't actually regret.
Yeah.
I don't regret breaking the bro code. Kerri and mine have something to say about that, but I don't regret breaking the bro code. I went in there for Angie and Angie only.
Yep. So you kept saying. Yeah. That's all you said. I'm here for Angie, Angie only. Oh, what did you ever say? I'm here for Angie, Angie only. I'm like, okay, yeah, I think we picked up on that. Now, hang on. You were a front runner. I am telling you, absolute. I was rooting for you. I had my money. I lost the bet now.
I'll pay you back later.
You're Nan died, and you really showed a real vulnerable, softer side. How did that all come down?
Yeah, so me, like, opening up my emotions, I'm not the best at it at the, you know, most best of times, but being in that situation, you have to be. Got to be very open and honest, and you got to put everything on the line straight away. Tell Angie that I'm leaving because of this and family reasons. Like, she totally respected it because, like, with Angie, family comes first. And
her nan had died the year before, so I know that she really...
Yeah, so that's another reason why I think it was so difficult and she let me leave at the same time.
Kerri-Anne, do you think you could have won? Do you think you had a hold on Angie's heart?
Yeah, I don't like to, you know, really toot my own horn, but I reckon, you know, you've got Carlin, who's really good looking and gorgeous, and then you've got Tim, who's just absolutely off his head and funny, and I felt like I was just slap bang in the middle and I could have straight to the finish line.
I think maybe you won her over with the nude light.
You won over the girls and all the gays, I know that right now. I have a conspiracy theory. We love our conspiracy theories. I have a conspiracy theory that somehow you're gonna find a way to get back in there at the last minute, be the white knight and come in with your white hair flowing. I'm here for Angie.
And my grapes.
Hold yeah, on. And your grapes. It could happen.
I feel like he knows too much. Yeah.
No, I don't. But I'm thinking of every possible way, you know?
Don't discount it.
Yeah.
Don't discount it.
Was that kind of freaky, getting all your gear off in front of not just the fellas, but also a potential gal?
It was like, yeah, live drawing, you've been like gonna be naked, whatever. I was like, yeah, bang, put my hand up straight away. Didn't even think about it. And I was like, oh, I'm just gonna be sat on like a little couch or something. I'll have grape shapes over or a monitory patch, it'll be fine. But that was definitely not the case. It was full frontal, whack it out in front of everyone. And I was but I'd already said like, you know, yeah, I'm gonna do it. And then I thought, oh, if I back out of it, then she'll think I'll back out of other things. And I was like, I'm a man of my word. Say I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna do it.
Was the air conditioning on?
Oh, it was freezing.
That's just me. That's not me.
He's claiming it was on 17 degrees, but I honestly didn't think it was that cold. He's claiming it was 17 degrees.
You said to Angie that if it doesn't work out with any of these idiots on the show, that you might be able to, she might be able to slide into your DMs. Yeah, slid into your DMs?
No, she hasn't slid in yet. So
Well, you know,
could have worked out with someone.
I think it could happen. Also, Jamie's last words are like, well, maybe one day we could get a coffee or something like that. And then the door slams. And no, it was like that. You said, oh, maybe we could get a coffee. And Angie's like, slam. Because you did pretty much lie to her face about Carlin.
No.
You lied about Carlin.
No, Carlin said that twice.
No, well, not that I heard.
Carlin said that twice.
What we're talking about is your allegation that Carlin said he actually wants to be the next Bachelor. The speculation now is, however, that maybe you might be the next Bachelor.
Yeah, there's a lot of speculation going on about that, and there's a petition apparently going around that people are signing because they want me to...
Look at me in the eyes. Yeah, there could be. It could be.
How would you feel about that? I mean, you clearly were forming feelings for Angie.
I know.
Are you open to 24 new girls?
Look, if the opportunity arises, I'm not going to say no, so I would do it.
Well,
if...
actually, it would be 23 new girls and Richard Reid.
No, I'm already with Jamie.
No, Jamie's found love. You found love.
Oh, you found love?
I found love.
What?
No.
Oh, my notes say here, right here, have you... Oh, no, it says, have you seen...
Okay, so no.
Have you?
I've been hibernating in a coal mine.
Oh, have you?
Since the show wrapped.
Oh, with a canary.
Yeah, right?
I work in a coal mine doing rescue as a firefighter, so I've literally been hibernating with a bunch of bearded, big, burly miners.
Oh. Well, that sounds like a Saturday night for me. But I don't think either of you... I don't think either of you are going to be single for long.
No.
You know, if that's the case. Yeah. I mean... I know I'm talking, everyone's talking, so I mean, I just think you're gonna have pick of the litter.
Pick of the litter!
What's wrong with that? Isn't that a... That's an American expression, I guess.
I've already said it's Thursday that you found love.
If there's a silver lining in all of this for me as well, is I did come in pretty strong about Angie and about breaking the bro code, and a massive byproduct of this for me is I've made some really good friends, believe it or not, and it's the last thing I expected. Like Ciarran, like Tim, Ryan, Jackson, Adam. There's a lot of guys that I've become lifelong friends with.
Well, good on you. I would
have never picked it.
Good on you,
when
mate.
That show began.
Yeah, that's fair enough.
You know what? I think it's been really great to see you guys, to see you fellas vulnerable. Because, you know, you see Aussie blokes and there's not a lot of emotion, but I've loved it. It's been great.
I feel like I sort of break the stigma for it, you know, like tatted up heavily.
Yeah.
This and that. Tried to be a bit boisterous when it comes to it. I'm just... Can't help but shed a little tear. I nearly cried watching that. That's the first time I've seen it as well.
Yeah.
So watching that, I was
do you want your jacket back?
No, I'm all right.
You're all right.
What's your nan's name?
Connie.
Oh, yeah. Connie.
Mary Constance. Yeah. Her nickname was Connie. That's all she wanted to be called.
You talked to her every weekend, didn't you?
Yeah. So when I was younger, living in the UK until I moved to Australia, I was there every weekend. I'd be with my nan. She'd take me to church. I'd do all that. I first Holy Communion. Altar boy, all that sort of stuff, and yeah, it was good. I enjoyed it.
I bet.
Did you make a mistake going out? Do you think, did you do the right thing?
Yeah, looking back on it, I probably did make a mistake because you know I think I could have been the front runner and smashed it, but I didn't, and whatever's meant to be is meant to be. I'm a big believer in that, and yeah.
You wear your heart on your sleeve, and good for you, and yeah, it's awesome. And you know what? If you don't come back, I pray you do. You both were damn good TV.
Yeah.
I gotta tell you, you made the show. The show rocks this season.
That's what I can absolutely say to people. Were you not entertained?
Yes, we love it. Make sure you tune into The Bachelorette at 7:30 p.m. on Wednesday. Fellas, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks.